Hello, everybody, and welcome to tonight's second game of the doubleheader here on your Friday evening as we just witnessed the Concordia Stingers men's team beat the Laval Rougeor in dramatic fashion, 87-85. Now we bring you the women's action as the Concordia Stingers take on the Laval Rougeor in this great CIS women's basketball matchup. As we see Laval win the tip-off early on. As we see Ferlin for Laval as they try to work it down low. We're going to get a quick travel call versus Laval and give Stingers the ball. As we see Carey open up for the Stingers. She gets it to Barrett. Finally to Profet. She goes in and she's rejected by the big Rougeor center, Nadeau. As we quickly get a chance to look at today's matchup.
Well, the Rougeor are in fourth place currently, playing against the second place Concordia Stingers. The Rougeor have five players that stand above 6 feet tall in this game. They're second in the country in defensive rebounds and first in blocks. So size is going to play a huge factor in this game, as we already saw. It's been one block in this game. Genois of the Rougeor and Kayla Barrett of the Stingers are definitely the players to watch here tonight.
As we see a foul away from the play by the Stingers, as my partner Mike Tushin was talking, we saw Catherine Grolot drain a three for Laval to give him an early 3-0 lead. So now we see Laval back on the attack. That's for Lan. She dropped to number six, Jobin. But that's off the mark, and the Stingers get the board. There's Beaulieu. Tries to get it and finally does to Jean-Philippe. And a shot from outside by Barrett is off the mark, and a rebound pulled down by the Rougeor. That lead pass is tipped by the Stingers as Barrett has an opportunity. She gets it to a Stinger who fell down and from her back tried to get a pass off, but that was blocked by Nadeau, but will remain Stinger's ball. Stingers are looking to try to get on the board here. 8:22 to go in this first quarter. So very early on. 3-0 Rougeor. Jean-Philippe with a nice shot. The 5'7 guard gets the Stingers their first points of the game.
Jean-Philippe, one of the veterans on this Concordia Stingers team.
The big girls down low working around and getting a good opportunity. Finally, they're able to draw a foul. That was Genois. So she'll go to the line, shooting two. The 6'2 center, as we mentioned. Big height advantage for Laval, especially if they can shoot from the line. That's going to be a dangerous combination.
Well, it certainly is, and Genois almost looks taller than what she's listed at, 6'2". She's huge out there.
She hits one for the Rougeor. We have a she hits both, makes it a 5-2 game. Jean-Philippe has it again. They kick it out to Barrett. Barrett now drives the lane, stops, and finds air. Stingers are having a tough time putting some points up 2.5 minutes in. We see Ferlin. Looks it around, and her pass is intercepted, but right back in her hands. Now she drives the lane. A nice little dish off, and they get the friendly roll, and a great assist from Ferlin. She got it to Belzil. And a quick 5-point lead for the Rougeor.
Well,
Is now a turnover by the Stingers once more, and they're having all kinds of trouble 3 minutes in. As they get it to Jobin, she finds Ferlin. Down low to Nadeau, and that's just swatted out of bounds by Jean-Philippe, and that's going to be a fresh shot clock for the Rouge et Or.
Somebody's going to have to tell the Concordia Stingers that this game has begun. They seem to be sleeping in the early goings here. Seems to be a common theme in the Concordia basketball teams, though.
So we see a couple of substitutions for the Rouge et Or, Lefebvre and Chapideau. Now on the floor, and that's a potential turnover that goes right in the hands of Lefebvre. Now a wide open three attempt, and she knocks it down. The big Rouge et Or forward, Genois. And the 6'2" Genois has some range on that shot.
Mentioned Genois is one of the players to watch. She averages 13 points a game and to go along with 11 rebounds.
And pulls off a very nice steal and an assist. So, well, sorry, I jumped to conclusions there as I thought they were going to put that layup in.
Counted that layup before it had even drained, and it didn't.
So Profet comes down and scores for Concordia. That was a missed opportunity for the Rouge et Or after some nice playing by Genois. Now another turnover by the Rouge et Or. Barrett gets it to Carey. She takes a shot and drains it. And all of a sudden, we got a four-point game as the Stingers seem to have woke up a bit.
Yeah.
Now the Rouge et Or swinging around. They try to go down low to take advantage of that height. And they do by drawing a foul by Chapideau. She'll go to the line. That's the third Stingers foul of the first quarter. None for the Rouge et Or.
Chapideau shoots 60% from the line. She is now 7 for 11 on the season. 1 for 1 in this ball game.
So an attempt, she goes 2 for 2, and they're taking advantage of their free throws in this game. Jean-Philippe has it. She's working. She's got a bit of a lane. Finally, she decides to take it, then kicks it out to Barrett. Back low, and that's a turnover. Right in the hands of Genois. And another turnover as they go back and forth. Brings it back to a four-point lead for the Rouge et Or. They drive baseline, and that goes off. Tried to drive. The Stingers are going to take a timeout down by 4 or 5. I'm going to look back at the previous game that the Stingers played here at the Concordia Gym.
Yeah, last Friday the Concordia Stingers hosted the then third, well, the UCAM Citadel, and were able to pull off a 73-68 victory. Because of that performance, they're now 2 points up on the Citadel and sit in second place. The Citadel do, of course, hold the game on hand, so they could tie things up. So that's why a win here tonight would be give them a little bit of breathing room, the Concordia Stingers. Super rookie Kayla Barrett, who assistant coach Rasko said, Rasko Popovic said, was one of the most athletic players in the country. Just had an absolutely explosive performance that night, despite getting suffering a minor injury and missing some playing time.
Should also be mentioned, too, about how the Stingers almost blew an 18-point lead, which would have just been a fiasco.
Yeah, Lupe fiasco, in fact. We were breathing pretty heavily up in the booth, as we usually do, when games get a little closer than they should be. It's Brian and I, of course, diehard Stingers fans.
That's why we enjoy bringing you these webcasts via SSNCanada.ca. As now we see an inbounds pass, and they're going to call that a foul on Barrett. A pushing foul. So that's going to send Laval to the line. It's going to be Jobin. They've already racked up 14 fouls, and they're going to be in the bonus pretty soon. They hit another free throw. Jobin now with a chance to make it an even two. And can't get the roll. Carey with the rebound for the Stingers. And Barrett with a chance to drive the lane, and that rims out. A nice board by Jobin. Little spinorama. Closely guarded by Profet. Instead, they just kick it out. Now Andrews Cote turns it over. That goes right to Barrett. Drives and then gets rejected by Chapideau, but will remain Stinger's ball. As we see Pont-Denis as well as Nikita Lee check in for the Stingers in place of Barrett and Profet. So we'll see how the bench does for the Stingers. As Bourdieu finds Carey, kicks it out to Jean-Philippe with 2 seconds. She lets up the three-pointer. That goes off the rim and out. And a rebound by Andrews Cote. Now they kick it all the way across the court as they find Genois, who's having a great game so far. She's hit from all ranges. In close, three-pointer, mid-range.
She sure is, and she's already up to 7 points on this ball game. It's a shame she's so tiny.
As we see another block shot for Laval, that was Alice Jobin. As they force their way through the key, and that goes off the Stinger last, and it's going to remain Laval ball. As we see almost a wholesale change, as three new Rouge Or come on. Nadeau, Dion, and Ferlin.
Ferlin doing her best impression of Brian Charlot on the court here tonight.
I assume that it's a knee-related joke.
No, just so athletic like you.
As they draw a chance for a three-point play, that was Genois. There's some pretty passing. As this game starts to widen out a little bit.
Cordia Stingers being doubled up. Plus one on the scoreboard here thus far. 3:12 to go in the first quarter. Score of 17-8. What is it with the Stingers basketball teams and slow starts, Brian?
I'm not sure, but you got to credit Laval right now as they're taking advantage of all their opportunities. I think they're perfect on free throws.
6-7. So they are not perfect as they are 6-7, but close enough.
And doing a great job down low, taking advantage of their size. And a nice little circus shot by Nikita Lee with a quick counter. And watch out, a little defensive breakdown and a smooth little off the window and in by Ducruc. And then a quick counter, and we see Nikita Lee once more as the game starts to open up a little bit.
Nikita Lee, of course, another one of the veterans on this Concordia Stingers basketball team.
As we see an almost turnover right into the hands of head athletic therapist Sean Christensen,
who plays coy with the referee, saying, "I'm not going to give it back." Ref says, "Give me that dang ball."
Little rascal.
Of course, Sean Christensen, no stranger to your knee injuries here at the Concordia Complex. Brian, of course, a former football player who has had multiple knee injuries.
Gives you plenty to banter about.
Yeah, well, I don't think I've ever brought it up before because it's such a touchy subject for you. I don't want to bring back any horrific memories, of course, but it is reality, Brian, and you're going to have to face it eventually.
I'll withhold my tears on the webcast. As we see some tight defensive play, and we're going to see a call against the Rouge Or, and that will give the Stingers the possession back. That was a five-second violation.
That pivot turned into more of a travel on that play, but referee said he didn't think so.
Regardless, Stingers' ball is Lee off the bench with six now. She's been a good addition so far.
Nikita Lee usually averages 4.5 points a game. She's already outdoing herself in that regard.
They work it down low, and a nice little shot doesn't fall for the big forward, Nadeau. Now, Carey looking under, and you got to watch out because these big forwards for Laval have very good arm reach and have gotten their hands on a lot of balls.
Well, an interesting matchup here tonight because the Concordia Stingers are second in the country in offensive rebounds per game, and the Rouge Or are second in defensive rebounds. See who's going to be crowned king and or queen, respectively, here.
As Nikita Lee hits another jumper, gives her eight on the night. Very early on, and she's only had about 3 minutes of play. Kicks out to Ferland. She turns it over as Carey moves it up quickly to Gregoire Boudreau. Back to Carey. We see a long two-point attempt from Carey off the mark, but a good rebound by Gregoire Boudreau. After you mentioned the offensive boards, there's a good one for the Stingers. As they're going to call a travel on a baffled Nikita Lee.
And a baffled Michael Tushin in the booth as well. I didn't think she lifted her right foot, in which was planted.
As a few grumbles go through the beehive. As we saw some questionable officiating in the first one. Not to get on their case right away, but we did see some questionable officiating in the first game of our doubleheader. And a nice play by Pondeni, but it will remain Laval ball with 13 seconds on the shot clock, 36 to go in the first quarter. They try to establish an offensive play. Good inbounds by Laval. That goes to Jobin. Gets it to DeCrook with 5 seconds to go. They're going to have to shoot. They get it down low and finally get a shot off that misses everything, so it'll be a shot clock violation. Good defensive job by the Stingers, and they're going to get a chance at last shot of the quarter as the shot clock is turned off with only 22 seconds to go. As Carey has it, she's going to take her time trying to work for last shot. As the Stingers have closed this gap to a four-point lead for Laval. A nice spin around when Carey draws the foul with 9 seconds to go. So she'll go to the line shooting two.
Kendra Carey, 59.3% from the line on the season.
Hits the first one with ease. As she avoided the rim and hit nothing but net. Now for a chance to make it two. And does. So some excellent shooting by Carey from the free throw line. Now it's only a two-point lead as the Stingers, as you mentioned, needed some time to wake up, and they did. And they work it down low. They're going to call that Rouge Or ball with 1 second to go. Not a lot of time to get a shot here.
Well, Concordia Stingers kind of saved themselves here in the first quarter. They were down by 9 points at one point.
So that will do it for the first quarter. A 20-18 lead for Laval, but as you mentioned, the Stingers have to be happy with that, with the hole they dug themselves early on.
Well, that's correct, Brian. as the Rouge Or only hold a two-point lead now going into the second quarter.
Going to take a two-minute break.
I think I've garnered one myself.
I agree. As right now, the Laval seems to be playing a lot better than their 4-8 record shows.
Yeah, they certainly are. I'm a little shocked at their 4-8 record, actually, because of their size. They seem to dominate the boards and being so good with the blocks as well. And someone who can shoot and have the athleticism as the tall woman, Genois, on this team. It's just, I don't know, I'm shocked. Clearly imprecise than I did. Short and sweet. Brian, of course, short and sweet in real life. We mentioned in this webcast, he's 5'4". Don't know how he ever had a career in football, but he did.
Started as a water boy, finished as a water boy.
How do you sustain so many knee injuries as a water boy?
It's a dangerous job.
Brian, of course, not blessed with the athleticism that I was, as people around these parts call me Mike the Athlete Tushin.
You usually only hear that when you're talking to Amir, but that's...
Who's Amir?
Hopefully they're going to get back to basketball really soon.
This break seems to be about 20 minutes long with this horrendous content of our conversation. Moving on.
So we see a fresh 10 minutes back on the board as we're going to get our second quarter underway. Thumbs up from the official. And we're going to see Pondeni get into carry. And we're underway. 20-18 lead for the fourth place Laval Rouge Or versus the second place Concordia Stingers. As we see an early foul to Laval, number 12. That's Dion. Now we see Carey finds a wide open play, and they cannot capitalize as Gregoire Boudreau had two chances, and the rim was just unrelenting.
Kept that ball from dropping. Windier than normal as far as indoor gymnasiums go. Of course, people at home can't get a feel for that.
So we'll see Laval back on the attack after a couple of lucky breaks, and we're going to see another foul to the Stingers. That's going to be Tina Pondeni. She picks up two quick fouls.
Well, seems a little softer on her feet than I had imagined, but nonetheless.
Those two quick fouls earn her a seat on a folding chair as they bring Profet back in. As that was almost a turnover on the throw-in. Finally, it's kicked back out to Andrews Cote with 7 seconds on the free throw and a nice play by Profet. Knocking the ball away right into the hands of Carey. And Gregoire has another chance. And Gregoire Boudreau really having some tough times around the rim right now.
Certainly are. Nothing appears to be dropping either. Calls seem to be going in the Rouge Or's favor here in this ball game. Conyu's 4 for 12 in the inside scoring right now. Going to need to up their percentiles if they want to have a successful outcome of this ball game.
As that's three fouls already to the Stingers 1 minute into this quarter. And with the way Laval's been shooting the rock from the free throw line, that could be dangerous. As Carey gets it up to Lee. Back to Carey. She's a wide open three attempt off the backboard and out. As we're being a bit of a scoring drought, these two teams, lots of chances in the second quarter. Nobody's got anything to fall. As we see another turnover, that's Andrews Cote. And a turnover once more, and the fundamentals have gone right out the window. Maybe that's where the breeze is coming from.
Perhaps. No points scored yet in this second quarter. It's still 20-18 with 8:27 to go, or affair for our Francophone friends watching at home.
And there's been nothing shy of an abundance of chances. And really how nobody's put anything in is baffling. There's another turnover by the Stingers, and both teams trying to up their defensive stats. There's a wide open shot is missed.
Renaud just goes down like a folding chair at will out there.
There's a long three-pointer misses, and another offensive rebound by the big forward Nadeau. And let's hope we can see some scoring for the rest of this game. Is the kick out to Jobin. She throws it up. But that'll be shooting two. Now for Laval, as Jobin going back to the line. As they can't earn the points during play, so they're going to try to get some free ones.
Well, I'd be satisfied if the only points that went up on the board were four for the Stingers. You'd go home happy. Maybe a little bored, because there'd only be 4 points from here until the end of the game.
Stingers now have 4 fouls going into this timeout with 7:40 to go. Next one puts them in. Laval into the bonus, giving them probably a lot of chances from the line in this second quarter as we look ahead. So both teams are probably going to bring their teams to the benches and say, you guys forget how to score?
You guys forget how to play the offensive game? It's the you are a Stingers fan of all sports. The Concordia women's team, ice hockey team, just lost 1-0. Oh, they're still playing. It's 1-0 for McGill. Okay.
In the second period, as you
in the second
jump
period.
To conclusions, I have more faith in our women's hockey team than you do, apparently.
I saw. Never mind. Just forget about it. I saw a couple of the...
Okay, let's not forget about it. Let's forget about it and then re-bring it back up. How about we make up our mind?
Forget about it.
As I jump all over color commentary, Mike Tushin. I'll apologize as he collects his thoughts. As I've already forgot about what he's going to bring up. So their first points of the quarter... Come 2:20 into it as Jobin gets a free throw to drop. The second one also to drop, and right now that's the only way anybody can get some points.
Rouge Or 8-for-9 from the free throw line here.
So now we see them drive, and finally some points by Yasmin Jean-Philippe for the Stingers. As it's 22-20 now. As now they get in low and a nice little spin move, but can't get enough on it to drop it. As scoring continues to be hard to come by. And now a tough play down low, and Profet splits the D and gets it to drop, and now we get a tie basketball game.
Oh, the offense has woken up here in the second quarter. Just like to mention, if you're a fan of Stingers hockey and other sports, the women's team trails 1-0 in the second period against the McGill Martinets. I don't think we brought that up yet.
Marlettes? Well, correct some pronunciation. It's the McGill Martlets.
Okay. We'll try it again next quarter.
As Profet for three and drains it. As now we got a three-point lead for the Stingers.
Concordia Stingers currently enjoying a 7-0 run. Or jog. Either or.
As now Laval trying to find their offense. They've only got 2 free throws to fall. And Jobin drives. And they're going to call that offensive Stingers ball. And it's a momentum-filled game, and right now it's all Stingers. We're going to see a timeout for Laval.
Just like to mention the playoff implications of this match. We mentioned that second place Concordia Stingers are sitting at 7-5 on the season and are currently 6 points back of the first place McGill
Marlets.
So I had it written down as Martinets here again for some reason. The Stingers are trying to stay ahead of the third place Citadin, who trail by only 2 points with a game on hand, as we mentioned before. Laval is holding on to the last playoff spot. They're 4-8, and they are 4 points above last place Bishops. So playoff implications of this game are pretty big. The Concordia Stingers trying more to stay ahead of the third place UCAM Citadin, as it's going to be pretty tough to catch the Marlets this season. As I finally got my pregame stuff out of the way with only 6:10 to go in the second quarter. Amazing.
Better late than never, though. So we have a 3-point Stingers lead, 6:10 to go in this second quarter. Some very good basketball starting to take place now at the Beehive. So it will be Stingers ball as Yasmin Jean-Philippe makes her way down on the Rougeor end. She kicks it up to Gregoire Boudreaux, still having some trouble in the offensive end. Gets it down low once more, draws the foul, and will go to the line. So hopefully she can find her scoring touch from the charity stripe.
The charity strike. Boudreaux is 63.3% from the line this season. And as you mentioned, she's just having all kinds of difficulty getting that ball to drop. So she puts your criticisms to rest here from free throw range.
So she's
from the line.
Your basketball, your basketball terminology is out of this world. Considering you used to be a former ref. As the Stingers extend their lead to 5, and Laval's just doing nothing but looking for answers. As they've only got 2 points this quarter, they're from the free throw line.
Looking for answers. They're going to want to shake that magic ball sooner or later because they're going to need to find there, and they did. There you go.
Jobin has a nice finger roll. As now they get it to Boudreaux. Down low to Profet. Can't get it in. And defensive rebound by Jobin. She finds Ferlin. She's looking for help. Gets it to Jobin. As now they get it to Genois. She drives the lane using that size and gets it to fall. 4 straight points for the Rougeor.
Genois now up to 12 points on the match and seems a little stronger on her feet later in the second quarter here.
Now Gregoire is cut off. And a long stretch pass. A nice play again by Genois.
The Stingers were on a 9-0 run, but that's been disrupted here by the Rougeor, who are now on a 6-0 run. And now lead the Stingers by 1 point in the second quarter.
As Marie-Michelle Genois continues her strong efforts in this first half. As now Brieux, as he gets it to Profet with 1 second on the shot clock, gets it up, can't get it to fall. And another good rebound by Jobin as Laval continues to use their size to get boards. And they're going to call that on Concordia. So a chance at a 3-point play.
Well, Genois really just taken over again in the second quarter here. She checked out from the halfway mark of the first quarter until now pretty well, but she drains this. They're on a 9-0 run. 8-0 nonetheless.
Can't get it to fall. And a nice board by Gregoire Boudreau. Nikita Lee can't find the mesh, and that one hits iron and out as Genoa even leads the rush now. She's doing it all. Finally dishes off to Ferland. And that shot's up. That's off the rim, and it goes right to Ferland. She kicks it out. Now Ducrook. And that's going to send the Concordia Stingers into bonus. Well, I guess Laval Rougeau into bonus, and that'll take him to the line. She'll be shooting too. So this will be Ducrook. As Andrews Cote checks in for Ferland. The first one is good. Now a chance to complete the two-point play, taking advantage of their bonus opportunity. And does is Ducrook, the six-foot forward, hits both. Now Jean-Philippe, as she gets it to Gregoire Boudreau, a nice little pass to Profet. Draws the foul, can't get it to fall, but will go to the line for two. As Ferland's going to check right back in. She got about a one-minute breather.
Laval Rougeau enjoying a 10-0 run.
So Profet's going to try to dig into that, but unsuccessful on her first attempt. As the Rougeau have extended their lead to five. Profet finally hits one to get the Stingers back in the scoring column after a bit of a drought. So now Ferland, after a quick catnap on the bench, is back out. Gets it to Andrews Cote, and a nice little steal by Carey. Can't maintain possession, though, but that squirts right up to Gregoire Boudreau, and now it's in Profet's hands. That switched possession about four times. Now it's going to be a long two off the side of the net.
More turnovers than the presidency of the Concordia University right now. Holy smokes. Judith Woodrow just stepped down, of course.
Although there was more than one turnover.
Well, there were several others. Their stay in office was shorter than Kim Campbell's, so I just cannot recall their names.
As now they work it down low, they go for a reverse, but that goes off the bottom of the net, and she gets a bit of a giggle about that attempt.
Well, I'm sure giggling myself.
We've been known to have a bit of a giggle problem up in the booth. If you've watched some of our previous webcasts. We had a tough time with the name Boogie last time. Not to bring it up again, but we giggled our way through that one.
I'm giggling as you just brought it up again.
There's now Nikita Lee trying to find some space. Gets it to Profet. Works away in the paint. Kicks it out to Carey. With 5 seconds to go, that shot finds nothing but air. As we have 2 minutes to go in this first half.
They keep drawing all the air down on the court. We need some up here in the booth. So we get a little winded during the games here. Brian and I, not in as good a shape as we once were back in our athletic days. Although I'm still pretty athletic for a bigger man now.
I don't know. We have run out of breath in every webcast, and all we're doing is talking. As now both teams are in the bonus with 2 minutes to go. So that might loosen up the defense a tad at either end. So both coaches talking it over with their teams. as I'm sure Concordia would love to cut this deficit a little lower before going into halftime.
Oh, something humorous just struck me. I thought of Boogie again from the last webcast. Concordia has only made 9 of 29 shots all game. And then free throws on top of that, of course. I just gave Max Caron a look like you're lying. That's crazy. It's an absolutely appalling stat. Remember, Rasko Popovic last game said if they shoot anywhere around the 40% mark, they'd be a little more comfortable.
Of course, I'm no mathematician, but I don't think that's around 40.
That's under 33, Brian. That's as quick as my mathematical brain can move.
As we go along at a snail's pace, thankfully we have a statistician helping us out. My 4 attempts at calculus did not pay off, apparently. And that passes by everybody. And
Charlotte, Ferland throws the ball out there.
That will remain Laval ball. And a turnover quickly by Lee, and she can't hold on, though, as she finds a streaking carry. Not literally, but figuratively, as she puts it in for two.
Nikita Lee is just having a heck of a ball game here for the Concordia Stingers as she pulls them within two with 1:25 to go in the second quarter.
As they work it down low, and another nice play by Genois. Put it back to a 4-point lead for Laval. It's Gregoire Boudreau now tries to find an opening, gets it back to Profet. Kicks it out to carry a wide open three. Is off the front of the rim and right into the hands of Ferland. The smallest one on the court comes up with a rebound. Ooh, and we're going to get a foul. That's going to send him to the line with 51 seconds to go. So we're going to see the 5 foot Ferland, 5 foot four Ferland, go to the line. She is registered as the smallest person in this game.
Her brother, of course, was once in the Montreal Canadiens farm system, John Ferland. Never really panned out for the Montreal Canadiens, but his sister having a pretty good career for the Laval Rouge Or. Back to you, Brian.
That first one just misses as it hit every part of the rim and bounced out. Now for his second attempt. Puts it up and off the front of the rim. She probably wants that one back because it was pretty short. As they get it back to Carey. Gregoire Boudreau with the long three off the rim. With 37 seconds to go in this first half.
Boudreau's struggles continue.
And now nice lay-in by Nadeau. And Stingers will have pretty much the last shot as the shot clock and game clock are even at 15 seconds. Carey now has it. She gets to Boulieu. They work back and forth. Boulieu with the three off the mark. But Lee makes a nice play. Then gets it out to Profet. And an excellent play by the Stingers forward, Nikita Lee.
Profet's going to go to the line for two here.
There is 2 seconds to go in this half. Profet a chance to make it a 4-point game going in, but she'll have to make both of these. She makes the first. Now for a second attempt. Hits both. Makes it a 4-point lead with 2 seconds to go as they spin and fire a long shot from three quarters. Can't get it anywhere near the net. And that will do it for our first half of action as the Laval Rouge Or, the fourth place team, go into the locker room with a 4-point lead over the second place Concordia Stingers. What'd you see in this first half that you liked? Or didn't like, for that matter?
Well, I don't know. In the second quarter, the shooting was a little futile for a while. What I do like from the Concordia Stingers is when they are going to the line for free throw opportunities, they are completing at a seven times out of eight right now. So they're doing very well when they're getting the opportunities. Compare that to Laval's 10 of 15. Stingers go to the dressing room. They're going to have to think of ways to shut down Genois in the second half of this ball game. Considering the slow start that they had in the first quarter, only being down 4 points in the first half is not such a terrible thing, but they're going to have to play catch-up basketball in the second half and hopefully have a little bit more success than they had in the first.
We're going to go to our halftime festivities. There's a couple of lucky fans have a chance to win a new mini fridge, although looking at their size, I doubt they have the strength to get it in from half court, which would they need to do to win a mini fridge. So they might be looking at the smaller prizes like a hot dog.
As I am a shade of my former self.
So now the first contestant drives the lane with speed and puts it up off the window, and maybe the paparazzi right in his face helped go against. And now the second attempt is she just misses it. Once more, the camera shy contestants may have been thrown off by the girl taking their picture, but nonetheless, they did it their best.
Sure did.
And you can't fault them for that.
I will. That was a horrible performance. Kids got to play hungrier out there so they can get these hot dogs. Maybe win a fridge. I want to see that fridge get handed off in one of these games.
Well, I'm glad your first half analysis for the Stingers was a little better than the analysis of the halftime contestants.
But a little more optimistic anyway.
On that note, we have 12 minutes and 30 seconds to go before the second half gets underway of our CIS women's basketball. The Laval Rougeaux lead the Concordia Stingers 36-32.